So, what should you know about 5G and why is it so important? 5G is the fifth generation telecom technology standard for broadband cellular networks. And of course, you've already felt it, right? Okay, just look around you. Every single day, more and more devices get connected to the internet. From the usual ones like your phone and laptop, to things like a smart scale, smart fridge, thermostats, or electric cars. Everything that requires internet connectivity will be using 5G technology in the future. But let's go a little bit back to the basics so we can understand how things work. If 5G is the fifth generation telecom network standard, it means that there were other generations before it, right? So, which came first? 1G, of course. Starting in 1979, 1G made possible the existence of the first mobile phones so that we could start communicating on the go and be mobile without the use of a landline. It was quite rare to see someone with a mobile phone back in the day, but the tech was promising. Next came 2G in 1991, which incorporated text messages into our cell phones. Do you remember the famous SMS? For those of you too young to remember texting before emojis and GIFs, SMS stands for Short Messaging Service. And for the 90s, it was amazing. But hey, good enough is rarely enough, so in 1998, 3G came out with new features. 3G gave us access to a new messaging system, allowing us to send and receive multimedia content such as photos and videos. And even better, since 3G had better speed for sending and receiving data, it offered the possibility of having internet communication services such as email and access to the web through a browser within our mobile phones. Not gonna lie, 3G was great, but 4G in 2008 changed the world. Like our boy Steve Jobs would say, the best G we ever made. 4G delivered the fastest mobile internet experience up to now and allowed you to use the web on your phone just like you were on your computer, with amazing speeds. You can now easily have high quality audio or video calls over the internet using services like FaceTime, Skype, or WhatsApp on the go without having to be connected to a wireless network at home. Or you could also stream any high definition videos in 4K in just a few clicks directly from your phone. Probably the same way you're watching this video right now. Then why can't we just stay with 4G? What does 5G bring to the table? Low latency. Latency is the delay between the device sending a request to the network and receiving the information back. 5G delivers an extremely low latency of just 1 millisecond, which is amazing for those all-night-long sessions of Call of Duty or Fortnite getting pounded by 14-year-olds. But also has more serious uses such as autonomous cars, for example, communicating with one another or with the infrastructure in real time to avoid any incidents. The average human reaction is 250 milliseconds. Now, imagine that your car would react 250 times faster than you. Other fascinating use cases for low latency will be immersive virtual reality gaming, healthcare monitoring systems, sensors for real-time communication in industrial applications, or remote surgical operations, also known as telesurgery. So, 5G will be the foundation that will unleash a massive Internet of Things ecosystem for billions of devices. A match made in heaven. Improved speeds. Depending on your area, 5G will allow you to reach speeds of anywhere between 10x to 100 times faster compared to 4G technology. With a max speed of 10 gigabits per second or 10,000 megabits per second, you will be able to download your favorite films, whatever genre you're into, in literally a few seconds. Connection density. Things are about to get crowded, so this is crucial given the increasing number of smart devices connected to the internet, as it will enable more efficient connectivity between them. 5G will be able to support 1 million connections per square kilometer, compared to around 2,000 connected devices per square kilometer on the current 4G standard. But why is this important? The Internet of Things. The Internet of Things refers to devices embedded with sensors, software, and other technologies to connect and exchange data with other devices over the internet. Just to give you an example, Alexa, which is Amazon's voice assistant, is an IoT service since it can control smart home products as well as other devices such as headphones or thermostats. And now, the million-dollar question. Should you be concerned about 5G's effects on your health? Could these radio waves be dangerous for our health or endanger our safety? Will 5G fry your brain or cause COVID? I will answer those questions and talk about other fascinating topics in the following videos. So make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. This is our first video of many. So let me know what you think about the new channel in the comments below. And to support us, it would mean a lot if you could gently tap the like button. This was Eduard Stinga from VideoPlasty.com, and I'll see you in the next video.